My name is Frank Elijah Nnabue. I have come again today with a word of God, and I believe you'll be blessed tremendously in the name of Jesus. Please kindly help me to share this video because I believe somebody's life is going to be blessed through watching this video today. If you have friends you want to invite to watch with us, please do invite them because I know God is going to bless somebody today through the name of Jesus. Amen. Today, by the grace of God, we'll be looking at Jesus has the master key to all doors. So many human destinies have been caged, imprisoned, or locked up. Some people's chapter on celebration have been closed. A lot of people have got good dreams, wonderful dreams, but they don't know how to access the doors that will lead to their greatness. And today, by the power that is in the name of Jesus, I have come. And today is not just preaching, today we'll be praying, and I believe God, as you connect with these prayers, that God of heaven is going to meet you at the point of your need, in Jesus' name. Amen. I want us to turn to the scriptures. If you turn with me to the book of Isaiah chapter 22, Isaiah 22 from verse 22, and Revelation chapter 1 verse 18, we'll be looking at the Revelation chapter 3 verse 7. Isaiah 22 verse 22 says, "The key of the house of David I will lay on his shoulder, so he shall open, and no one shall shut, and he shall shut, and no one shall open." Revelation 1:8 says, "I am he who lives and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore." Amen. I have the keys of Hades and of death. Revelation 3:7 says, "And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, this thing says he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, he who opens and no one shuts, and shuts and no one opens." Hallelujah. Jesus has got all the keys you may need in this life. And even after this life, Jesus has got the key of death and life. Jesus is the key that unlocks every door, every human destiny, whoever I want to be fulfilled. The key to every fulfillment is in Jesus. Hallelujah. So there's no chapter of your life that Jesus cannot open. There's no chapter of your life that Jesus cannot open. So you have access to any mystery of life through the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So today I will be speaking these things based on different subheadings. But the first one I want us to look at today is Jesus has got the capacity to open doors that the enemy has closed. Jesus has got the capacity to open doors that the enemies has closed. Doors like favor. A lot of people are struggling today because the door of favor has been closed against them. No matter how they invest, no matter how hard they are working, yet nothing seems to be working because the door of favor has been closed against them. But I've got good news for you today. That the door of favor shall be opened unto you again in the name of Jesus. Some people's door of marital bliss have been closed. So many marriages today are suffering. No wonder we have a very high number of divorce, even in the church today, because the door of marital bliss have been closed. But I declare to you today, if you're married and your marriage is struggling, I declare that the power of God will visit your marriage. I declare the door of marital bliss is open right now in the name of Jesus. A lot of people's door of financial breakthrough have been closed. Door of financial breakthrough. They struggle in life. They invest in businesses. They are working hard, but they have nothing to show for it. Some people are laboring day and night. They wake up early, go back to bed late. Yet they can't feed their family comfortably. Yet they are still looking for money to meet their needs. But I've got good news to you today. Everything that's making you to lack, everything that closed your door to financial breakthrough, I command today in the name of Jesus. They are open now in the name of Jesus. Amen. A lot of people's door of healing have been closed. So many people are sick, even in the body of Christ, because the door of good health have been closed. But I've come with good news. I command the door of your good health to be open now in the name of Jesus. I command it to open now in the mighty name of Jesus. Some people's door of carrying their own children have been closed. They cannot access that chapter. Maybe the chapter of financial breakthrough is open. They are blessed financially, but the door of fruitfulness, having their own children, have been closed. But I've got good news to you today, that the power that is in the name of Jesus, that door of carrying your own children, that door of fruitfulness, I command it to be opened now in the name of Jesus. Amen. And also, it's not just opening doors. He also closes doors that the enemy has opened. So are you listening to me now? No matter the doors that have been closed in your life, I command them to be opened now in the name of Jesus. And any door that the enemy has opened, you know, some people today, the enemy has opened door of hardship. The key to close that door is through the name of Jesus. The key that closed that door of hardship is through the name of Jesus. A lot of people, the devil has closed it, has opened the door. Opened the door of untimely death. Door of grave. Door of death. Door of sicknesses. Door of poverty. But I've got good news for somebody today. That the mighty name of Jesus, every door of poverty, every door of untimely death, every door of shame, every door of reproach, through the power that is in the name of Jesus, I command them to be closed now. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So I declare you will not die before your time. You will live to enjoy your wealth. You will live to carry your great-grandchildren. You will live in good health to fulfill your destiny here on earth. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Also, God opens the door. The name of Jesus opens the door. Brings divine connections. I don't know if you have been stranded in the journey of life. I don't know if you are listening to me right now and you don't have destiny helpers. People are not coming to your aid. But I declare through the name of Jesus, that door of divine connections is open now. From today, people shall come to your help. People will come and decide to help you. I decree right now, your destiny helper shall locate you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So I declare right now, every door of pain, every door of reproach, every door of shame, every door of fear, every door of delay, every door of limitation, every door of imprisonment, every door of disappointment, by the power that is in the name of Jesus, I command them right now to be closed in the name of Jesus. I decree you will carry your children. I decree you will count your millions. I decree you will fulfill your purpose. I decree you are going to become what God has ordained you to be. And nothing will ever stop you. In the name of Jesus. Amen. If you turn with me to the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 16 verse 19. The Bible says, "And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you lose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." I declare right now, listen to me. The power to bind and to lose is through the name of Jesus. And I declare you are going to begin to walk in that name. You are going to begin to walk in that name. I declare through the power of the name of Jesus, your life shall begin to shine forth in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Bless you. Listen to me. There are ways to open doors that have been locked. Two good things. I'm going to give you two keys, two wonderful keys to access any door that the enemy has closed against you. And the first one is key of obedience. Obeying the word of God. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 6 verse 33, "But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing you desire shall be added to you." In Psalm 34 verse 4, the Bible says, "Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart." So when you dip yourself into the word of God, when you obey God, God gives you the desires of your heart. Amen. So I want you to know that God is doing some amazing things even right now in your life. But for you to assess it, you need to begin to delight yourself in the Lord. Another key is the key of praise and worship. Praise and worship. We read in the book of Acts chapter 16, verse 25 to 26, "But at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly there was an earthquake. that will be a suddenly in your life. Every door where the enemy has placed you in, I declare as you obey the word of God, as you praise God, there will be a sudden earthquake. I decree your deliverance in the name of Jesus, amen. So that the foundation of the prison was shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's chains were loosed. When you praise God, the Bible says God inhabits in the praises of his people. Hallelujah. But before we go into prayers right now, I want to give you the opportunity. If you have not made Jesus your Lord, if you have not surrendered your life to him, I want to give you the opportunity to say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Because any prayer we're going to pray today may not benefit you until you make Jesus your Lord. That is the entry point into the kingdom of God. So say after me, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Be my Lord and my personal Savior. From today, I will serve you forever. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you have said this prayer, get in touch with us. And now I want us to go into prayers. Amen. I want us to go into prayers right now. Wherever you are, I want you to declare upon yourself that any door that the enemy has closed against me, against any member of my family, I command you door to be opened now. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and make it a prayer. Any door the enemy has closed against you, I command it to open now. Every door to your marital bliss, I command it to open. Every door to your financial breakthrough, every door to your spiritual growth, every door to your happiness, every door the devil has closed, I command it now to be opened. In the name of Jesus, I want you to begin to pray for yourself. Let those doors be open right now. Let those doors be open. Doors closed against you by the kingdom of darkness, I command them now to be open. I command them now to be open. I command them now to be open. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray for yourself. Any door of affliction, premature death, I command you right now be closed. In the name of Jesus, begin to close every negative door that the kingdom of darkness has opened against you. Begin to use the name of Jesus. Begin to use the word of God. Begin to close them now. In the name of Jesus, I command right now, every door of affliction is closed against your life. Every door of premature death, every door of poverty, every door of shame, every door of reproach is closed now. It's closed now. I declare, you are rising up from that door in the name of Jesus. Every door of disaster, every door of disappointment opened against you is closed now. It's closed now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Listen to me. I believe God has done some amazing things in your life. Go ahead and share this video. God bless you.